He has to put himself in our shoes. What we are feeling by missing our families.
A blow to dozens of families here in the Treasure Valley. Refugees waiting to be reunited with loved ones are told those family members aren't coming to the U.S. as planned after a recent executive order signed by the president.
KBOI2's Kelsey Anderson talked with one man who knows what it's like to be separated from loved ones.
It was unbearable, but I didn't have a choice. I have to do that.
Dauda Balabwila, a refugee who fled war and torture in the Democratic Republic of the Congo, got separated from his family for more than 5 years.
To see kids with their parents, someone with his wife, it was so painful for me.
This, something as simple as watching TV as a family, was a scene he thought may never be reality again. But the waiting ended last summer. A day he'll never forget, August 2nd, 2016, he was finally reunited with his wife and kids. He says that day, he started living again.
What I felt that day, it was very difficult. It was like a dream. When I saw them, I was asking myself, it's really them? I was so happy that day. It was the best day for me here in Boise.
So how did Dauda get his family to Boise? Well, he used a form called I-730. Refugees use that form to get their spouses and kids under 21 to the U.S. to be with them. They can fill it out within the first 2 years of being in the States, but a recent executive order signed by President Trump indefinitely suspended all I-730 applications.
When a war happens, people flee, and they flee in all different directions. And sometimes one part of a family goes one way and the other part of the family goes another way. It's not like there's a lot of time to coordinate, plan, and make choices all together.
Julianne Donnelly-Zuhl, the executive director of the International Rescue Committee, a resettlement agency in Boise, says she sees a lot of separated families. She says 37 I-730 applications were pending when that order was signed. That's 37 kids and spouses who will remain separated from the ones they love. And when we met with Dauda, he got a phone call from a friend whose wife was on that pending list.
It doesn't make sense. It doesn't make sense.
He says that man on the other end is just one of many local refugees now left wondering when they can truly start living the new life they imagined with their loved ones by their sides. In Boise, Kelsey Anderson, KBOI 2 News.
Now, without the I-7.